For the lab, this is a video about the lab procedures specifically. For the labs, these are, you know, pandemic times, so you're not going to be going into the lab. Instead, you're going to be watching videos and using PowerPoints and or PDFs that we've made of the lab materials and trying to fill out the lab assignments and also be able to answer the questions at the end, which are largely conceptual. So they're not really specifically about doing something, although it might require that you understand an experiment. So hopefully the videos will help you do that. What you're going to be submitting, and the best way to do this is you can either, let me start over. You might want to buy a lab manual, because if you buy a lab manual, then you'll have the labs and you'll have the questions all together. And what you can do is fill out the lab book, take a picture of the part that you need to submit, and then just upload those into like a Word document or a PDF or something like that to submit it. Now, to submit something, it has to be in a text format, a JPEG format, or like a PDF. It can't be in any other kind of format. So you want to make sure that you do that. I do provide the labs for you though, so if you want to, you can just print them off. You don't have to buy a lab book, you can just print them off and or, you know, just upload them in your computer and then, or download them to your computer, and then you can fill them out. And then the question portion, you will need to somehow like fill it out and submit it. All right, so sometimes that requires making a graph or something like that, or drawing a picture. So it's kind of easier if it's printed out, but you know, some of you guys can probably figure out how to do it otherwise, and especially depending on the lab. So whatever way is the easiest and the best way for you to get this done, that's good, that's fine. So again, my suggestion is buy the lab book, fill it out by hand, take a picture. If that's not what you want to do, there's these other options, okay? I'm going to be dividing you guys into lab groups. I'm going to divide you into groups of four. Of course, you know, people will probably go in and out of those groups, and that's okay. What I would like you to do with those groups is you're going to use them to interact with other people in the class, so at least you have some people that you get to know in this online scenario. And they can be your study group as well. And the thing about the lab groups, I'm going to designate a group leader. That group leader is going to be the one that is submitting the lab. So you're going to hand in one submission per four people. So whatever your group is, let's say, you know, you have four separate people in your group. You have one person that's the group leader. After discussing all the questions, that person is going to submit the assignment that you guys have all discussed and agreed on the answers for. And this will be, you know, explained perhaps a little bit better after I divide you guys into groups, but that's the basic idea. The way I suggest that you go about doing the labs is that you first individually watch the videos and try to fill out your lab book. And then try to answer the questions at the end. What you're going to be submitting is the review questions at the end of each lab. And that can include something called apply your knowledge, or sometimes they just called it apply your knowledge. So review questions, apply your knowledge, that's the part that you're going to submit. You're not going to submit the part that is just the lab procedures and the things that you were supposed to see in the lab. Now, I do recommend that you fill all that out, because when you study for the lab exam, those kinds of things will be helpful. And you'll want to have gone through the labs at least once. And because you're not physically there, it's really important that you read it over and try to figure out what you would have seen. All right. And then after you've watched the videos and filled everything out, then you should get with your lab partners and go over the answers that you guys all got and try to agree on the answers. So that way, if you got something wrong and somebody else says something, you guys can discuss the answers and try to come up with what you want to submit. Also with things like graphs and stuff, make sure that if you don't know how to do the graphs, that you try to do them and have your lab partners help you make them better. All right, so if somebody in the lab is really good at that, don't just let them always do the graphs and so forth, because part of what you're supposed to learn in this class is how to do graphic representation of data. So make sure that you take it upon yourself to do that. And then, you want to designate a group leader. You can tell me who that group leader is, and if nobody tells me, I will designate one. All right, so make sure that you tell me that. And then you will submit one lab per group. Of course, all these labs are better done in person. You know, really, this is not how we would normally like to do it. Some of the questions within the lab are kind of impossible. You know, they say, which way do you turn the knob? You know, you don't know because you're not actually turning the knob. So don't worry about questions like that. What you want to really get out of these labs is the concept, and you want to get the general idea of what the experiment is and how the experiment showed you a specific concept or activity or cell part or something like that. All right, so make sure that you are kind of taking it in the spirit of that. Most of the information you need is directly in the video or the PowerPoints that are provided. So if you feel like they're not, ask me before you submit and say, I couldn't find it. All right, so because it's there, you just don't, you may be looking in the wrong place. So you want to make sure that you, if you don't think you can see it, let me know and I'll tell you like if it's there or not. All right, so any questions, let me know. To study for the lab exams, I have a little document there, but you're going to basically want to read over each of the labs and go through each section. And for each section, you want to know, what was that section trying to show me? How was this experiment set up, if it was an experiment, or what were the reagents used, or what did the experiment look like, or what was I supposed to see? What happened in the experiment, and or what should have happened in the experiment. Of course, on the videos, it all happens. In reality, it might not have all happened. That is, if you were doing it. And then the other thing is what were the results, or what was the concept that was shown? And you want to do that. Like if I gave you a feedback, make sure you incorporate the feedback that I gave you. I grade these labs a little bit hard. The reason is this is not a big part of your grade. It's only 10% of your grade. So it's a place that I can kind of say, nah, you're kind of off base here. You don't really get it. And you can ask me questions about that and try to use it in that vein. Don't worry about making a perfect score on the lab because you might not, and that's okay because it's not a big part of your grade. It won't bring you down very much. Some people have really only gotten like 50% of the labs and still made an A in the class. So, you know, it's no worries to that. And then make sure for the other things, that you want to make understand that the lab exams are again online, and they do use honor lock, so you want to make sure that you review the honor lock procedures and that you are ready with a webcam and a microphone when you take the exams. All right, so again, if you have any questions, let me know.